The solid-state drive, or SSD for short, is a type of long-term storage that, unlike traditional hard drives, has no spinning disk inside. This design allows SSDs to provide extremely fast read and write speeds. They also offer additional benefits such as silent operation, compact size, and increased reliability. However, today the cost of SSD is still about as twice as high as a traditional hard drive for the same capacity. The most important specifications of the SSD that you may encounter are memory cell technology, connector type or form factor, protocol and version that it uses, maximum read and write speeds, and the endurance rating and warranty. Memory cells are mostly made from flash memory using NAND gates. Depending on how many bits can be stored in a single cell, the SSDs divide into several types: single layer cell, multi-layer cell, triple layer cell, quad level cell, and penta level cell. Technically, the last three are subtypes of the multi-layer cell, but manufacturers and retailers often use MLC to specifically refer to drives with 2 bits per cell. Generally, storing more bits in a single cell reduces the overall speed and longevity of the SSD, but provides higher data density, allowing for larger capacity drives to be made at lower costs. PLC drives are currently under development, and we may see even more bits per cell in the future. Another term that you might encounter is 3D NAND or V-NAND, which indicates that the cells are stacked vertically instead of horizontally. This structure provides several benefits, the most important of which are improved endurance due to the larger cell size and the higher storage density. SSDs were initially designed as a direct replacement for the traditional hard drive with a 2.5-inch form factor and SATA port. For laptops, mini SATA SSDs were also introduced, taking advantage of the technology to further reduce the size and weight of the drives. However, manufacturers soon realized that the speeds were being bottlenecked by the SATA interface, so they started using the PCI Express bus for faster data transfer. Initially, PCI Express SSDs, which looked like an expansion card, were released on the market, but they had some drawbacks, like their large size, which made them incompatible with laptops, and many computers couldn't boot directly from the PCI Express slot, which limited their use as an OS drive. For laptops, mini PCI Express SSDs emerged using the PCI Express interface, but the slot lacked support for SATA standard devices. This led to the development of the M.2 slot, which supports both SATA and PCI Express. Since its introduction, the M.2 has become standard for both desktop and laptop motherboards, but more on that topic in another video. M.2 SSDs come in two types, SATA and NVMe. Non-volatile memory express is a specification for non-volatile storage devices that use the PCI Express bus. If an SSD is marked as NVMe, it typically uses 4 lanes of the faster PCI Express bus. You can easily distinguish them by the missing pins. If it's SATA SSD, it will have both B and M notches. If it's NVMe SSD, it will have only the M notch. When installing a SATA SSD in your computer, check your motherboard's user manual first, as sometimes not all M.2 slots support SATA SSDs. M.2 SSDs come in various sizes, such as 2230, 2260, 2280, and others. The numbers follow a standard naming convention where the first two digits represent the width of the drive in millimeters and the remaining digits represent the length of the drive. For example, 2280 will be 22 millimeters wide and 80 millimeters long. The size of the drive must be compatible with the M.2 slot on your motherboard, as not all M.2 slots support all sizes. Additionally, SSDs are available as external devices connecting via USB Type-A or USB Type-C ports and utilizing either the USB protocol or Thunderbolt protocol. These external SSDs offer the convenience of portable storage combined with the high-speed performance. NVMe SSDs differ from one another based on the version of the PCI Express that they use. The first generation NVMe drives utilized the PCI Express Gen 3, while newer models now use Gen 4 or Gen 5. Typically, higher generation offers higher maximum speeds. However, Gen 4 drives tend to be more expensive than Gen 3, and Gen 5 drives can be almost double the price of the Gen 4. Therefore, I would recommend getting a Gen 5 SSD only if you seek the absolute maximum performance. For most users, Gen 3 or Gen 4 will be fine, as you will likely not notice any difference at all. When it comes to SSD speeds, most manufacturers and retailers advertise the maximum read and write speeds. However, these speeds are only achievable during sequential data transfers and may be limited if the SSD begins to overheat. Other important metrics that you might encounter in benchmarks include 4K read and 4K write speeds. These tests measure the SSD performance when moving 4 kilobytes blocks, usually from random locations on the drive. They reflect more accurately the everyday performance of the SSD. The reliability of the SSD compared to the traditional hard drive is a debatable topic. On one hand, SSDs eliminate the risk of mechanical failure, are more resistant to shock, and can operate at higher maximum temperatures. On the other hand, the memory cells in the SSDs wear out with each write cycle, and sometimes they fail without warning signs. Additionally, data recovery from a failed SSD is more challenging. While modern SSDs have significantly improved the endurance, I would still recommend getting an SSD for your operating system and programs only, while storing the important data on a separate hard drive. In this way, you can enjoy the best of both worlds: high speeds for everyday tasks and safety for your data. Nevertheless, performing regular backups will eliminate the need to worry about data loss. The endurance of an SSD is typically measured in terabytes written, which refers to the total amount of data that can be written to the drive before the memory cells begin to degrade. TBW is a crucial indicator of the SSD's longevity. The higher the rating is, the longer the SSD is expected to last. Manufacturers usually offer warranties based on either a specific period of time or certain TBW threshold. Endurance can also be influenced by factors like memory cell types and the controller technology. Modern SSDs commonly use memory cell technologies such as TLC and QLC, which bring down the cost and allow for bigger capacity drives to be produced. Along with that, technologies like SLC caching, wear leveling algorithms, overprovisioning, and advanced controller technology ensures that the speed and endurance are not compromised. While TBW gives a good estimate, the actual lifespan can vary depending on the type of usage and environment factors. Thank you all for watching. Please like the video if it was helpful, and subscribe if you want to see more interesting videos like that. See you soon!